Hi, everybody. I'm Noemi. I'm the daughter of Chaim Perlman and of Fela Perlman.
Let me tell you the whole story. Belgium was invaded in May 1940. And at that time, I was, and the exodus was my mother and family. We walked trying to escape the Nazis, their advance, while my father was in the Belgian army. At some point, we walked and walked and walked, and whatever little belongings we're taking along were left on the side of the road along the way. I traveled with 3 teddy bears, and pretty soon it was 2 teddy bears and then 1 tiny teddy bear. At some point, the road was blocked. We were told we couldn't go any further, and so I came back with my grandparents to Antwerp, which is the town where they lived. I was not in a closet or in an attic. I had an assumed name, a phony history, a phony explanation as why I was living with those folks, a story that probably nobody believed, ordinary people who risked their lives, who did amazing things just because it was the right thing to do. Mother told me later that she would occasionally come to where she knew I was at school and watch me from afar, making sure she wouldn't get close enough for me to see her. The Liberation Day was one of the most joyous days of my life. The American Army came into Brussels, their trucks and tanks and whatever, and everybody went on the street. And I remember rushing to wherever, and I was picked up by the American soldiers who were so happy after I've been fighting the Germans, you know, and being in ugly places. Suddenly they are in a town where everybody welcomes them and loves them, and they see children. Right? This was so joyous to see children. So I know that I went blocks, many blocks, on the lap of an American soldier who picked me up from the ground, put me on his lap and on that truck. And they were so happy to be able to hug a child, which they had not done. I don't know who this guy is. He didn't speak French. I didn't speak English. We had no language. But there was the joy that these men had come to save us. The one thing that we need to do is always be vigilant. And when you're given an order, question whether this is morally right, because it's so easy to just follow the crowd. Father had hoped that I would work with him in philosophy of law, so I studied law and some philosophy, but he would have been very surprised if I had stayed in Belgium. I fully intended to be an attorney, to enter the bar and to practice law. But life took a different turn. I married this guy here, to whom I've been married for 50 years.
happily most of the time.
Chagrin, mes plaisirs, je n'ai plus besoin de balayer les amours avec leur trémolo, balayer pour toujours, je repars à zéro.
I came to the United States and I wound up, after searching and looking for my way, I wound up being a psychologist.
Hold me close and hold me fast, this magic spell you cast, this is la vie en rose. When you kiss me, heaven sighs, and though I close my eyes, I see la vie en rose. When you press me to your heart, I'm in a world apart, a world where roses bloom. And when you speak, angels sing from above, everyday words seem to turn into love songs. Give your heart and soul to me, and life will always be la vie en rose. And when you speak, angels sing from above, everyday words seem to turn into love songs. Give your heart and soul to me, and life will always be la vie.